Hello students, in the previous video we have seen stability constant and instability constant. This is called a stability constant in a formation equilibrium reaction. If you find the constant value, that is only called stability constant, which is denoted beta. For association, see, formation, then dissociation. Dissociation constant is called alpha. This also called instability constant. Then we brought the relation between stability constant and instability constant. Beta 1 by alpha. So beta and alpha inversely proportional. That beta value is higher means which having more stable, the complexes are more stable in condition, but alpha value high means they are less stable. So more stable complex, less stable complex. So we can find based on the beta value and the alpha value the stability of complexes. So now the beta value based on substitution, how to find, we are going to see by using substitution of ligand in the complex we can find beta value, that is stability constant value. See, step by formation or overall formation, first we will see the overall formation complex. Overall formation complex. What is an overall formation constant? Or we can say beta overall. Formation reaction, we know that any complex formed in a reaction, that is called formation reaction. In the formation reaction, if you find the constant, that is formation equilibrium constant, that is only called stability constant beta. It may take place step wise or overall single step reaction. So for overall reaction, if you find the stability constant, we can say beta overall. Beta means stability constant. For overall reaction, we can say beta overall. Let us consider a metal in aqueous medium. Any metal in aqueous medium. What will happen? The water molecules may surround metal atom. If you take metal, aqueous medium means what? We have taken water. This water will surround the metal atom. So likewise, metal atom will surround, water molecule will surround the metal atom. But we need to form complexes. Then what will happen? Ligand may approach the metal, but the ligand becoming very stronger means the ligand can replace the water molecule. Then the ligand metal will form metal complexes. So in generally, metal in aqueous medium, what will happen? The water molecule will surround the metal atom. Due to surrounding of water around the metal atom, all the ligands easily cannot form the complexes. Only the stronger ligand can replace the water molecules. By replacing the water molecules, ligand will form the complex compounds. This step may take place in a single step or stepwise. So single step means all the ligands may replace all the water molecules, it will form the complex. This metal surrounded by water can be represented M-S-6. How do you represent? Always we cannot write metal, water molecules are surrounded. Then simply we can refer this water surrounded metal M-S-6. Okay, so M-S-6 refers water molecules are surrounded the metal atom. Now ligand, simply we can write L. So the S refers water solvent, due to solvent, because water here taken as a solvent, due to solvent we have written S. The solvent may be replaced by ligand, so it will form ML. All the S may be replaced by L means it will form MLC. So this is complex. So aqueous medium to complex formation may take place in a single step. If it is takes place in single step, that is only called overall reaction. So overall substitution takes place in a single step means we will get overall stability constant beta overall. Let us see the complex. Consider we are going to prepare MN6. What are we going to prepare? MN6. How do you prepare MN6? We have to take MN6. S for solvent. So water molecules surrounded metal atom. It may be reacted with ligand. Now what will happen? The 6 ligand may replace 6 solvent. Now what will happen? The product ML6 with 6S. So substitution takes place, replacement takes place. Now for this reaction, it is also an equilibrium reaction. Remember, we are studying, finding that instability constant or stability constant always in equilibrium reaction. Right. For this reaction, stability constant, how do you find? Beta. Concentration of product. What are things we have in the product side? ML6. One more? S. What is the coefficient? 6. That should be written in the power. Then reactants. M, S6, L6. So I just written based on this equilibrium reaction. How do you find the beta value? Concentration terms of product divided by concentration terms of reactant. Let us take that S value. S is nothing but solvent. So solvent means always we take excess quantity. So due to excess quantity we are taking, this concentration of S is negligible. So we do not take it in the account because we will take excess amount of solvent. Because of solvent, that S character concentration we can leave it. So remaining beta ML6, S will not come, ML6. So this constant only for overall stability constant. Overall stability constant, because this reaction, substitution, replacement takes place in single step. So the ligand water molecule or solvent exchange takes place in single step, means we can say overall formation reaction. For that overall formation reaction, if you find the constant, that is called overall formation constant, beta overall. Formation constant means nothing but stability constant, beta. Let us see, for the same reaction, step wise, the ligands are replaced. One by one, we are going to add L and we are going to remove the F solvent. For the same type of complex, let us see stepwise reaction. First step, we have M-S6. All solvent surrounded metal atom. We can take one ligand. So it is also an equilibrium reaction. Here the stability constant we can measure with K. What will happen? Only one ligand approaching this metal. So one of the S may be replaced by one ligand L. So what will be the product? M. We have remaining 5 S, 1 L. Then 1 S is replaced or taken out. For this reaction, formation constant, how do you write? K1. So only one, first step, you can say K1. So what is the constant? As usual, concentration of product divided by concentration of reactant. What is the concentration of product? M S5 L. Then S concentration you have to write. But previously we have seen the concentration of solvent, we can leave it due to large quantity of solvent. We are taking as a solvent, solvent always takes it, we can leave it. Then reactant side we have concentration of M S6 L. So this is first equation. In the first equation, we got stability constant K1 is equal to MS5L divided by MS6L. Let us write second equation. You take the same product as a reactant. Write second S5L. The second step, we are adding one more ligand. Now another S may be replaced by this L. So step wise you can substitute L value. Yes, one is reduced, L one is increased. So we will get one more S value. How do you write the formation constant for the second equation? K2 is equal to concentration of reactant M S4 L2 divided by concentration of reactant M S5 L, then L. Same way we can take the next step. What we got in the second equation, that only the reactant for third equation. M S4 L2. Take one more ligand. Now the third S is replaced by this ligand. So we will get M S3 L3 plus S. For third equation, how do you write K value? K3 is equal to concentration of product M S3 L3 divided by concentration of reactant M S4 L2 with 1 L. Okay, right? For the next step, bring that product
as a reactant, M3L3 plus one more L, what will happen? Another S may replace by this L. So we will get M2L4 plus L. Then K4. M F2 L4 divided by M F3 L3 L. Next equation, take this step. M F2 L4 with one more L. Now, one of the S may replace M F L5 plus S. K5, how do you write? K5, M, S, L5 divided by M, S2, L4, L. So, final equation, we have one more S, so we can substitute with L, M, S, L5, L, all are equilibrium reaction. So the last S also replaced by L. M, L6 plus S. So what will be the K6 value? K6 value as usual. M, L6 divided by M, S, L5, L. So from that we can understand step wise how the ligand substituted or replacing the solvent. So we are adding one ligand, replacing or taking out one solvent. So we got each step the formation constant values K1, K2, K3, K4 and K5. They are called stepwise stability constant. What's the name? Stepwise stability constant. So by mathematical manipulation, we can bring stability constant beta value. So by using these all these K1, K2, K3, K4, K5 and K6 value, we can bring beta value. For that, what will you do? We have to multiply all stepwise stability constant. So beta for overall reaction is equal to K1, K2, K3, K4, K5, K6. For simplification, we can take log both sides. Log beta is equal to log K1 plus log K2 plus log K3 plus log K4 plus log K5 plus log K6. So if you apply the values, we can get formation constant or stability constant value beta. So by the way, we can find stability constant value in single step as a overall stability constant or stepwise stability constant. From the stepwise stability constant also we can bring beta value. So we have completed the stability of complex compound. The next topic, applications of coordination complex. See, there are many uses and applications we can see for complex compounds. Applications of complex compounds. Particularly, this is applied in plants, animals, as well as minerals. So minerals may form as a complex compounds. Let us see one by one. First one, pale blue. So pale blue is nothing but copper complex. It is giving blue color pigment, bright blue color due to presence of copper 2+ ion. So in the complex, if you have Cu2+, copper 2+ ion, it will give bright blue color pigment, which is used in printing ink as well as packaging industry. So packaging in the sense are not covering, as a preservator we can use this complex phthalo blue. So phthalo blue is used for printing ink as well as packaging industry, which is giving blue color. Then second use is purification of nickel. Nickel we can get purification, the pure, very pure nickel we can get by Mohs process. In the first lesson we have studied Mohs process for purification of nickel. So the nickel metal can be purified by Mohs process. In this method we will get 99.5% pure nickel. Next, EDTA, one of the chelating ligands. For purification of nickel we use the Mohs process. Okay, how complex used in this process, because nickel tetracarbonyl compound only we need to prepare. That means for purification of nickel we are making the nickel into complex. By making this complex we are getting pure nickel. That's why one of the uses or application of complex. Then chelating ligand, EDTA. So what do you mean EDTA? Ethylene diamine tetraacetate, one of the tetravalency compound, sorry, hexavalency compound. We may study during the Navy system how to write the structure. N CH2 CH2 N CH2 COO minus. This is the structure of EDTA. Any ligand like calcium, this forming means it will connect with the calcium. Now this is form one ring structure. This ring structure only called chelating ligand. Any ligand during the formation of complex forming ring structure means they are only called chelating ligand, right? So EDTA here also can form another ring. So due to ring formation of EDTA called chelating ligand. So this chelating ligand EDTA is used in the separation of ligand, sorry, laminate. What is the laminate? In the F block we know there are two rows. First row elements are called laminate. So that laminate element we can separate by using this chelating ligand EDTA. And also we can use in softening of water. What do you mean softening of water? So hard water, usually we are using RO water, you know. So salt water, we can convert into drinkable water. So in this process we can use EDP also, and also it is used to remove lead poisoning. Lead metal, we know that plumbage, BB. So one of the poisonous metal, unknowingly if you eat or our body got lead, we can remove the lead poison by using EDTA chelating ligand. The next one, by using volatile compound, we can extract certain metals. Extraction, the first lesson we may study metallurgy. Extraction, separation of metals, particularly gold and silver extraction. From the ore, we need to form complexes. We are converting ores into cyanide complexes. The cyanide complexes may be, can be reduced by zinc. We can get pure metal. So the separation of metal, we can use particularly gold, silver metal can be separated from its ore by converting cyanide complex. The cyanide complex further reduced by zinc, we will get the metal. This process is named by Mock-Arthur-Forbes process. Mock-Arthur-Forbes process. This process is very important for extraction of silver and gold because they are inert metals. It will not easily react with any other compounds. Due to that, we are using extraction of gold and silver, Mock-Arthur-Forbes cyanide process. In this process, what we are doing, the ores of silver and gold, we are converting into cyanide complex. The cyanide complex will be reduced by zinc, we will get the metal. This process named by Mock-Arthur-Forbes process. The next one, estimation of metal ion. So in particular solution, if you want to estimate how much percentage of metal is present, that you can do by forming complex compound. Estimation of metal ion. What do you mean estimation? We can measure the quantity of metal by forming complex. Let us take one example. Nickel, from nickel chloride. So here, nickel 2 plus from nickel chloride, if you want to estimate. You just remember, we have given it on beaker. That beaker containing nickel chloride. You have to measure how much amount of nickel present in this solution. That is only called estimation. So in this estimation, if you want to measure the quantity of nickel, we have to convert this nickel chloride into complex compound. By converting complex compound with a dimethyl cyanoxide, DMG. DMG means what? Dimethyl cyanoxide. Dimethyl cyanoxide ligand, if you use, it will convert into nickel dimethyl cyanoxide complex compound. From this complex compound, we can count or measure the quantity of nickel. That is only called estimation of metal ion. So we can measure the quantity of metal ion by forming complex. That is also one of the applications for complexes. See, metal complexes use many reactions as a catalyst. metal complexes used as a catalyst. So catalyst we will study in 10th lesson. Catalyst means we know that if you want to increase the speed of reaction or decrease the speed of reaction, we can add certain compounds or certain elements. They are only called the catalyst, right? So many complex compounds used as a catalyst in organic reactions as well as inorganic reactions. One of the very familiar catalyst, Wilkinson catalyst. So what is Wilkinson catalyst? Trimethyl phosphate rhenium chloride. Rhenium triphenyl phosphate chloride. This complex compound only called Wilkinson catalyst. What is the use of this complex? Hybridization of alkene. In the alkene, if you want to add hydrogen, we can use this Wilkinson catalyst. Hybridization of alkene. The next catalyst, Ziegler-Naperoff catalyst. Ziegler-Naperoff. Ziegler-Naperoff catalyst is nothing but titanium tetrafluoride with dry ethyl aluminium. C2H5 means ethyl group, dry ethyl aluminium. This mixture of titanium tetrafluoride and dry ethyl aluminium, mixture only called Ziegler-Naperoff catalyst. This Ziegler-Naperoff catalyst used in polymerization of ethene. Polyethene we are preparing, you know, polymerization of ethene. Like we can prepare polyethene, polyethylene or polyethene we can prepare. The next uses, we can use the superior uniform spreading of superior metal on base metal. Usually the inert metals, what are the inert metals? Silver, gold, platinum are called inert metals. That inert metals usually do not react with other compounds. Due to that, we are applying uniform distribution of metals like gold and silver. They are called superior metals. On base metals, other metals are called base metals. On base metals, if you want to uniformly spread out that silver or gold, we can use the complex compound formation. How do you use the complex compound formation? We can make the silver into silver cyanide. Same way, gold is into gold cyanide. By converting as a complex, we can spread out uniformly on the base metal. Superior metals like silver, gold, platinum can be converted into complexes. The complexes used to spread uniformly on the base metals. The next one, medical uses of complex compound. Many metal complexes used as a medicine. Let us see two medicines. One is calcium PDPA. Already we know that to remove lead poison, we can use the EDTA chelate and also radioactive poisoning. Both are lead also one of the radioactive elements. So let poison we can remove. Or in your body is there any radioactive element we can remove by using EDTA, calcium EDTA chelate used to remove poisonous lead metal or radioactive metal from the body. The next metal very important is platinum. Cisplatin, this is used as an anti-tumor drug. So anti-tumor drug which is used in treatment for cancer. So to remove the cancer we can use cisplatin, one of the complex compounds. See important properties. So phototherapy, both the days, we were used only negative films. To what? Develop the negative film, we can use particular chemical compound like sodium thiosulfate solution. Sodium thiosulfate solution. That solution makes the film into get fixed. So already it may be negative film. If you wash with that sodium thiosulfate, it will be get fixed. It will be attached. Is there any unreacted silver bromide? The excess. See negative films contain silver bromide. On washing this sodium thiosulfate, what will happen? This excess of silver bromide with sodium thiosulfate forming complex, soluble complex, we can remove by washing with water. It will form sodium dithio. Excess of silver bromide with sodium thiosulfate solution is forming the complex sodium dithiosulfate complex compound with sulfate. Silver complex compound will form, that is arsenate 1. So in this chapter we know how to give the name for complex compound, right? So one of the complex compound name nothing but sodium dithiosulfate arsenate 1. Let us see the chemical reaction between the excess of silver bromide and sodium thiosulfate solution. Silver bromide with sodium thiosulfate. Now it will form complex compound. NaBr. So due to this complex formation, the excess of silver bromide is washed by water. In case we are not forming this complex, we cannot remove the excess of silver bromide, it becoming poisonous compound or may not be useful to print out the photos. So the excess of silver bromide can be washed away by sodium thiosulfate in this reaction, which is forming complex sodium disulfate arsenate 1 complex compound. We can wash that compound by using water. So we have seen many applications in chemical reactions as an industrial purpose or medicine purpose we have seen. Now we are going to see particularly biological systems in plants and animals, how the complex compounds are used. The first one, very important well-known one, RBC, red blood cell. R corpuscles. So red blood cells or red blood corpuscles, which is only main complex compound which is to used to carry the oxygen and carbon dioxide from the lungs to part of the body or part of the body to lungs. You just remember, we are inhaling oxygen. Why we are inhaling oxygen? Our body contains many millions of cells. For the respiration of cells, which need oxygen. So we are inhaling oxygen from the atmosphere, which reaches our lungs. In the lungs, who is carrying that oxygen from the atmospheric air? That is nothing but hemoglobin. That hemoglobin nothing but iron complex, iron tetramethyl atom with 4-valent complex, 4-valent ligand. This complex only forming as a hemoglobin. This complex is used to carry oxygen from lungs to part of the body. CO2, carbon dioxide, is carried from part of the body to lungs. Listen carefully. RBC, that is nothing but red blood corpuscles or red blood cells, which contains the complex compound, which is called hemoglobin. Hemoglobin means iron tetramethyl atom and 4-valent group formed one complex. That complex only called as hemoglobin. That came through, which is only used to carry oxygen from lungs to part of the body. As well as part of the body, we have cells. The cells donating the CO2. That CO2 is carried from part of the body to lungs. This transport work done by our human body and animals, nothing but hemoglobin. Hemoglobin, one of the complex compounds. Let us go with the plant. Chlorophyll. So the chlorophyll, another complex compound which is present in plants, green plants, as well as algae. So this algae and plants having chlorophyll complex. That chlorophyll complex is nothing but with central metal atom magnesium. In the hemoglobin, central metal atom Fe2+. In the chlorophyll, central metal atom magnesium 2+. That magnesium 2+ is attached with ligand modified 4-valent complex. Here also 4-valent complex, but it becoming modified 4-valent complex. This complex forming like ring structure. So this one is, this is called chloride ring. See, 4-valent ligand with metal, iron, which is called hemoglobin. Magnesium with modified 4-valent ring is called chlorophyll. Together we can call it chloride ring. But the use of this chlorophyll, mainly which is used in photosynthesis process. In photosynthesis process, what happens? Carbon dioxide with water, this chlorophyll converts oxygen and carbohydrate. So this chemical reaction takes place due to this chlorophyll. This process only called photosynthesis. So the photosynthesis process takes place by chlorophyll. Chlorophyll, one of the chemical complex compounds. So all these uses we have to remember. Then we can go with vitamin B12. One of the vitamin with metal atom, that is vitamin B12. Vitamin B12 is nothing but cyanocobalamin. So from the name itself we can remember cyanocobalamin. It contains cobalt 3+ metal ion. So only the B12 vitamin contains metal ion, that is nothing but cobalt 3+. That's why we are calling cyanocobalamin. This is also forming 4-valent ligand. The complex cyanocobalamin formed as a 4-valent complex. The long uses of complex compound, many enzymes means nothing but in the biological process they are used as a catalyst. Chemical means we can straight away say catalyst. In biological process we are using as a catalyst means they are called enzymes. So these enzymes maximum metal complexes. So enzymes, what they are doing, they are regulating the biological process. So many biological process regulated by enzymes. Enzymes nothing but metal complexes. One of the examples we can see, carboxypeptide. Peptidylase, which is nothing but protease enzyme. The protease enzyme that gives hydrolytic enzyme, which is important for digestion. It gives hydrolytic protease, which is used for digestion. In the digestion, we need the protease enzyme, which is also a carboxypeptidase, one of the complex compound enzyme, which contains zinc central metal atom. This complex contains zinc central metal atom, which is coordinated with protein. So we have completed this 5th unit, coordination compounds. We will see in the next video. Thank you.